Welcome to the first lesson of English language, grade 4, lesson number 1, Achu. What are we going to learn today? Today we are going to learn lesson 1, Achu in your English textbook. In this session, we are going to learn why and what makes us sneeze, what are the manners we should practice when sneezing, the different ways to greet one another in different situations, appropriate solution for situations, problems and different conditions, a few difficult words and their meanings. Okay, now let's read the lesson together. Lesson 1, Achu. Can you remember how you felt when you sneezed last? We all sneeze sometimes. Sneezing is something that your body does automatically. That means you cannot make yourself sneeze or stop once it has started. When you sneeze, your body is trying to get rid of bad things in your nose, such as bacteria or dust. When you have extra germs inside your nose, you sneeze a lot more. You might also sneeze when you smell pepper. If you can see inside your nose, you will notice that inside your nose there are hundreds of tiny hairs. These hairs filter the air you breathe. Sometimes dust and germs can find their way through these hairs and tickle your nose passage. When that happens, the nose tells your brain that something is coming inside your body through the nose. Your lungs, nose, mouth and the muscles of your upper body work together to blow away the dust or germs with a big sneeze, achu. When you sneeze, germs from your nose get blown into the air, adding them to the environment around you. So when you sneeze, it's always better to cover your mouth and nose with a handkerchief. When we do not have anything to cover your nose and mouth, sometimes you may use your own hand. If you use your hand, it is very important to wash it after you sneeze into it, especially if you have cold or flu. Do you ever sneeze when you walk into bright sunlight? Some people say that happens to them often. Scientists say that UV rays of the sun tickle the nose, making people sneeze. What would you do if you sneeze in public? Well, if you sneeze in front of somebody, don't forget to say, "Excuse me." At the same time, if someone nearby sneezes, remember to tell them "Gesundheit." That is a funny looking word which is pronounced as Gesundheit. It is a German word to wish someone good health after sneezing. It is similar to our way of saying "Are you born?" just after we hear someone sneeze. Okay, now it's time for questions. First task, comprehension, task 1. Let me read the questions for you. Why do people sneeze? Is it something we do purposely? What makes us sneeze? How does the hair inside our nose help us to keep ourselves healthy? These are the answers for first 4 questions. First one, when dust or germs enter the nose sneezes to get rid of them. Second, no, we do it automatically. Third, germs, bacteria, dust, pepper and UV rays make us sneeze. Fourth, the hair inside our nose filter the air we breathe. Okay, moving to the last 3 questions. Question 5. What is the most important thing to remember after you sneeze into your hands? Sixth one, explain how the sneezing takes place after dust enters your nose. Seventh, what should you do when you sneeze in public? Here are the answers. 5. Wash your hands after you sneeze into your hands. 6th, after dust enters, the nose sends a message to the brain. Then brain again sends a message to the nose to sneeze. Seventh, cover your mouth and nose with a hanky. Say excuse me after sneezing. Comprehension task 2. Complete the following passage using the words from the text. You have to find 8 words from the text. Okay, here are the answers. Let me read the text with the answers. Sneezing is something we do automatically. That means we do it without our knowledge. When germs or dust enter our nose, the hair inside our nose try to stop them from going inside. When it could not be done, the nose sends a message to our brain making us sneeze. When we sneeze, we release many germs to the environment. So it is better to cover your nose and mouth when you sneeze. Okay, now let's move to the writing tasks. This is task 1. Use the following words in sentences. You have 5 words: remember, noticed, wash, believe and forget. Okay, here are some example sentences. You can make your own sentences, children. First one, I can remember her birthday. Second, teacher noticed that they are talking. Third, my mother washed the dishes. Fourth, I believe in myself. Last one, I forget to bring my library book every day. Okay, now we will do task 2. Match the following situations with how we should greet. Situations, first, your friend has passed his exam. Second, at a funeral to greet the relatives of the dead person. Third, you meet a friend after a long time. Fourth, at your friend's birthday. Fifth, your friend goes on a long journey. Greetings, many happy returns, congratulations, deepest sympathies, I'm glad to see you, oh, after a long time, bon voyage. Okay, here are the answers, here are the correct situation with the greeting. First one, your friend has passed his exam, congratulations. Second, at a funeral to greet the relatives of the dead person, deepest sympathies. Third, you meet a friend after long, I'm glad to see you, after a long time. You can use both. At your friend's birthday, many happy returns. Your friend goes on a long journey, bon voyage. Listening and speaking task 1. Read the given situations and their solutions given in the bubbles. Do a role play giving your suggestions. Okay, now we are moving to the last part of this lesson, word bank. Find out the meanings of these new words introduced to you in the word bank using the Oxford Mini Dictionary. The words are extra, automatic, tiny, important. Here are the meanings I found: extra, more or additional, automatic, working by itself or done without thinking, tiny, very small, important, great value. Now we have to use those words in sentences. Here are the example sentences I found: extra, I have an extra pencil. Automatic, my father has an automatic car. Tiny, there is a tiny insect on the flower. Important, he has an important meeting. You can be creative and make your own sentences, children. Today we learned the lesson Nachu. Through this lesson, we got to learn why and what makes us sneeze, what are the manners we should practice when sneezing, the different ways to greet one another in different situations, appropriate solutions for situations, problems and different conditions, a few difficult words and their meanings. That is all from me today, children. Thank you. Have a nice day.